We have sent hundreds of weapons inspectors to oversee the disarmament of Iraq. Our good faith has not been returned. Peaceful efforts to disarm the Iraqi regime have failed again and again because we are not dealing with peaceful men. Before the day of horror can come, before it is too late to act, this danger will be removed. All the decades of deceit and cruelty have now reached an end. Saddam Hussein and his sons must leave Iraq within 48 hours. Their refusal to do so will result in military conflict, commenced at a time of our choosing. For their own safety, all foreign nationals, including journalists and inspectors, should leave Iraq immediately. In a free Iraq, there will be no more wars of aggression against your neighbors, no more poison factories, no more executions of dissidents, no more torture chambers and rape rooms. The tyrant will soon be gone. The day of your liberation is near. The terrorist threat to America and the world will be diminished the moment that Saddam Hussein is disarmed. American and coalition forces are in the early stages of military operations to disarm Iraq, to free its people, and to defend the world from grave danger. On my orders, coalition forces have begun striking selective targets of military importance to undermine Saddam Hussein's ability to wage war. Every nation in this coalition has chosen to bear the duty and share the honor of serving in our common defense. This will not be a campaign of half measures, and we will accept no outcome but victory. God bless our country and all who defend her.
Choose this war. Saddam Hussein was given a choice by the international community. Give up your weapons of mass murder or lose power. He chose unwisely, and now he will lose both.
Location where it was believed that very senior Iraqi leadership was located, including, an official says, Saddam Hussein. The hope was that they would be able to take out some of the Iraqi leadership, including perhaps Saddam Hussein, and vastly simplify the task of trying to prosecute this war against Iraq.
I want to go to a picture that's just coming into us from Al Jazeera television. That's on Rim 14 in the booth and is now on your screen. And this is the most recent explosion. We watched as a fireball was set off. I believe that this is live in Center City in Baghdad. And now clearly the cruise missiles are raining down on Baghdad, and the early explosions have begun. Whether this is shock and awe or not remains to be seen, but certainly for people who are witnessing this inside Baghdad, it must be shock and awe indeed. These are pictures coming to us from Abu Dhabi television, I believe, and live pictures inside Baghdad. And you can hear the anti-aircraft fire and what appears at least to be more strikes by cruise missiles, believed to be Tomahawk cruise missiles, which are dropping over Baghdad. Let's listen.
The top of the carrier deck, and that will mark the arrival, the beginning of the arrival back to this carrier of the first strike package into Iraq as part of this new air campaign in Iraq. And at any moment now, we are expecting the arrival back. Captain Fox, in his briefing, said to the pilots that were assembled in this ready room, that he said to the effect, gentlemen, you'll never forget this day. This package is going downtown.
Everything that we set out to do, everybody's back safe and sound from the first wave. I've got another wave that's out, that's going, and another wave that's coming back right now. So we're in this at we're at added hammer and tong.
Captain, you are a veteran of Desert Storm, first day of Desert Storm. You had the first Navy shoot down. Now you're leading men on the first day of this air campaign. Tell me what it was like as you're inbound.
Well, it's actually the honor of a lifetime to be in this position. I mean, to have so many wonderful, patriotic Americans working for me. It was a pretty visceral experience. I mean, I had a couple of hops in Desert Storm that were equal to it. If the difference from then to now is we didn't fly on night vision goggles back then. So everything that you saw then was with the naked eye, and now you've got an ability to see a lot more. So I don't know if that's necessarily a good thing or not, but there was a hell of a lot of stuff to look at tonight.
To American forces and those of our coalition partners, let me say this. Know that we are proud of you, that we stand with you today. We have every confidence in your courage, your tenacity, and your ability to get this job done. All Americans hold you and your families in our thoughts and prayers today.